Welcome to Programming Languages. I'm Wes Weimer, and together we're going to learn the theory and practice of programming languages, culminating in the construction of a web browser. Our web browser will accept as input HTML and JavaScript, the primary languages of the web, and use that to produce an image of the web page. You may already be familiar with HTML, which describes the basics of web pages, and we'll certainly go over it in this course later on, but you may be a little less familiar with JavaScript, which allows one to describe computations that take place on web pages. This gives us a lot of power and also a lot of flashy graphics. Let's see some examples. This particular web page, chosen more or less at random, uses JavaScript to animate these tabs for its title bar at the top. This is a second example of a web page that uses JavaScript, both here at the top for this sort of floating tooltip, but also down here at the bottom to animate the differences between these textual boxes. If we look at the source for one of these web pages, we can see that it contains both HTML and JavaScript right from the start. So let me give you a brief overview, in pictures more or less, of how this course and the overarching project will go. We start with the source to a web page, which is in HTML and JavaScript. Our next main step is to break that source into important words, just like we could break an English sentence into important words. Then we'll understand the structure of the words that we found. For example, focusing on this part down here, it may be easier to understand 1 plus 2 plus 3 as a tree showing all of the computations. And then finally, we'll figure out the meaning of that structure. For example, in this case, maybe all of that adds up to 6, and that's what we'll display in our resulting web page. Building a web browser will be a lot of fun, but the overall goal of this course is not actually to build a production quality browser, but instead to use the goal of building a browser as a way of structuring our exploration of computer science. So let's get started right here in step 1.